This episode of In the Making is brought to you by Ting, mobile that makes sense. I've seen robots stand, walk, jump, fly. This year at Maker Faire, I stumbled across two robots that move in a very unique way.
This is Glida, my new hexapod robot. He's running under full inverse kinematic control, which means I can throw an XYZ coordinate to the end of the legs, and the software will back calculate the motor angles needed to put the leg there. And what that means is that I can use smooth curves and ellipses in the software, and I can just generate ellipses and circles and throw the XYZ coordinates to the software, and it will move the legs smoothly. And you see, you end up with a much more organic motion. So inverse kinematics is really a wonderful way to program your robots. So it gives you a lot of flexibility. And I realized that by putting wheels at an angle on the leg, when the leg is out to the side, I could have the wheels engaged but not the feet, and he could skate. So you end up with a robot that can walk off-road through extreme terrain, and when it reaches a flat and level surface, it can transition to skating and move at speed.
Just as Glida caught my eye, a neighboring roboticist stopped by to check out her moves.
We built Titanoboa, a robotic snake.
Very cool.
We're just like on basic XY slithering, and we're using frame base where we're just sending each vertebrae to an angle.
Yeah.
Because that's like the level that we've got.
So frame base works, but when I started doing the math,
We've never done the math on Titanoboa. We've just been like, send it to an angle and the thing slithers, so we're good. But
It's worth doing the math. Like, I honestly thought the math was going to be a lot more complicated than it was. But when I actually started analyzing it, and I realized it was all just sine and cosine. It flew out pretty quickly.
Titanoboa is an electromechanical recreation of a snake that existed 50 million years ago that was 50 feet long. So we wanted to recreate it with a robot. The next step is to finish the final 10 vertebrae. So right now it's got 20 powered vertebrae, and the full snake will have 30 powered vertebrae. So we're over this silver summer, we're gonna finish the hydraulics and all the wiring and the wiring harness. We also need to get proper control of the vertical cylinders. Right now we're just going side to side, and to tackle like dirt and sand and gravel, we need to have good control of up and down.
Glida may be beautiful with her smooth moves and mathematics, but when you look at Titanoboa, you definitely have to say, size matters. This episode of In the Making is brought to you by Ting. No hidden admin fees or obscure charges. If you want to see how much this will save you, go to inthemaking.ting.com and use their usage calculator. This link will also give you $25 off a device or a $25 service credit. Ting, mobile that makes sense. Hope you enjoyed the show, and click subscribe to check out weekly episodes of In the Making.